Yo, what is up, everybody? Welcome to episode 2 of The Breakdown, where we really just show you the daily life, show you guys the back ends of everything, the good times, the bad times.
Do you feel the buzz, or is it just me? Trust me, something in the air just above me, something like a dream state, you call it a clean break. Do you feel the buzz, baby?
And we just wanted to have a quick conversation today. We don't have no laptops right now. We're not doing no work right now, but just wanted to have a quick heart to heart with you guys. So yeah, let's
start. Yep. And we're actually doing things a little differently. So we're actually in the air right now. We're actually flying in a private jet.
Yeah, that's why we're holding the mics like this, so you guys can hear us clearly.
Yep, exactly. So the topic we're really going to talk about is really how we got here, in terms of, like, you know, and also understanding that really a part of our journey is filled with failure.
Yep.
And we fail consistently every single day. It's a part of our journey, really, and it's enjoyable and fun to fail every single day.
Exactly.
You know, it's not about your wins. When you stay consistent at something, you're going to consistently fail. If you're not failing every single day, you're not really trying a lot of new things. So we want you guys to understand that you really have to just stay consistent in everything that you do.
Exactly. And part of it is we legit preach the same thing. You know, the formula is simple. Pick one thing, stay consistent, and be patient. Equals, eventually you might be successful, you know? So the part that really started resonating with us the most especially was the beginning, when we weren't seeing any results. Like, at the beginning, it's so easy to give up. That's why so many people don't last. They quit too early. Like, you never know when your time is coming, right? Mm-hmm. So if you quit right when your time is coming, that means you did all that work for no reason. That's why we just, like, never gave up, never quit. And honestly, I still don't even think we're successful yet. I still don't think we've even made it yet, because there's another level to reach. There's people that are bigger than us. There's people that are doing things much bigger than us, much better than us. So if you get in your own way and you said, oh, I made it, let me get comfortable, that's the moment I think you start declining. And I really want to talk about that, because a lot of people just start feeling like they're successful out of nowhere. I don't feel like we're successful yet. I still don't think that yet.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah.
I know there's another level we could reach, you know? So the moment that there's another level I can reach, that means I started again from zero. You know, whatever I accomplished in the back, that happened. That's done for right now. What's next? Like, that's why I really respected what Kevin Hart said when he came out with What Now?
Yeah, yep.
He said, I have accomplished all these things in my life. I did all these things. But okay, what now? Like, what's next now? And that's, I think, the mentality that I want to start sharing with everybody, is we recently switched our mindset to that, because it's so easy to feel comfortable. It's so easy to feel like you made it. It's so easy to think you're on the next level. But there's people who are 100 times bigger than you. If you're the best in your room, you're in the wrong room. Just being honest, you know?
Absolutely.
So let's get into that a little bit, on just like how, like, we don't let anything get to our head, and I still feel like we're still at level one. You know,
absolutely,
what I'm saying?
And the biggest thing is really staying out, getting outside your comfort zone. You know, consistently surrounding yourself with people who are doing better. You know, like right now we're surrounded with, you know, our other entrepreneur buddies who are actually, you know, really motivating and inspiring us to do better and consistently keep going. And honestly, it's really about who you surround yourself with. We keep repeating this all throughout all of our content, but it really, to be honest, that's the secret to it all. Because
it's
when you consistently are just around a group of people who are consistently pushing you to win every single day, there really is not an easier way to just, you know, succeed, other than just look who's around you, constantly audit your circle, and consistently just, like, put yourself amongst winners. So that's the biggest thing.
And how my whole thing that I always wonder is, it's not like more about like where you are right now.
Mm-hmm.
That's the biggest thing, because this whole game's a puzzle, right?
Yeah.
So when you play a puzzle and you're selecting every single piece, it's so easy to get frustrated and quit, because you don't get the whole thing right away. A puzzle takes a long time.
Mm-hmm.
And I think our entrepreneur journey is a puzzle. You know, I find one thing, I put it in. Now I gotta look for the next thing to put in the right place, and that takes time. So that's why I really like that, and I think we could resonate with that a lot, you know?
Absolutely. Yeah, so that's honestly what we wanted to remind you guys with. Stay consistent, consistently fail because it's important.
It's okay to fail. That's another thing. Like, people don't know that though. Absolutely. Not a lot of people say that. It is literally okay to fail, you know? And that's why, honestly, we started this breakdown series, is we show you guys the good, the bad, the failures, the things that suck, the things that are not fun, the things we don't like, the back end of everything that so many people don't talk about. You know, with everybody, you just see the good, you just see the fun stuff, you just see the glamorous, but there's so much dirty work behind the scene, and we're gonna bring you guys along to see all that so you understand, like, we fail too. So if it's okay for us to fail, why isn't it okay for you to fail? You know what I'm saying?
100%. So stay failing, you know, and be important to amend the circle around you. Consistently audit that.
Consistently.
And, yeah, to be honest.
Yeah, and don't have negative energy around you. That's absolutely big. Like, any negative energy, it's just being more toxic to yourself, especially at the beginning where you need a lot of, like, motivation and a lot of energy and a lot of fuel. Can't fuel yourself with negative energy at the beginning. That's why so many people quit at the beginning. It's, they think it's them, but it's actually just the people around them, simply. You know?
It's true.
If you're around people who are the same step as you, you're not gonna fail. It's like so slim of you failing. That's why I always say, get an accountability partner when you're first starting. This is what I did. When we were first starting, we held each other accountable for everything. Hey, are you waking up this early? Hey, are you doing this? Like, I was he was holding me accountable, I was holding him accountable. So if you have an accountability partner, which is so big, that's gonna help you a lot at the beginning stage.
Absolutely, you know? Yep. So we wanted to leave you guys with those few gems, and this is the episode 2 of the breakdown.
Breakdown.
Where we actually go and show you guys the inside of our life every single day. So stay tuned for the next episode.
Yes.
Peace.